Hello, my friends. I welcome you to another episode of Aditya Talks. And well, today we have a special guest with us, and she is Supal ma'am, and she is a highly motivated, energetic, and a committed trainer who is fully dedicated to helping individuals flourish and achieve excellence in all walks of life. So, welcome to the show, ma'am. How are you?
Thank you so much, Aditya, for that warm welcome. And I'm all good, very much excited to be on your show. And I think it's truly a pleasure and a privilege, I would say, to be here. Thank you so much for that, because the initiative, the work which you are doing through this show, you are truly giving a treasure box to everyone through the series of interviews which you are taking right now at this age particularly. And I'm so happy to see that, like a champion you are working, Aditya. So kudos to you for that.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Well, it's my honor that I am able to interview the likes of you. Well, let us begin with the interview. Please tell us about your journey from managing balance sheets to training on soft skills. How did it all happen? And please tell us about your highs and lows of your journey.
Absolutely. I love answering this question and, you know, sharing my journey. And thank you so much again for that question. Well, I would start like that, Aditya. I've always believed the mantra of my life is that every day is a chance to change your life. The moment you think it is possible, then the magic begins, right? So that's what exactly happened in my life. And, you know, from managing numbers or maybe auditing balance sheet, I'm auditing people right now, right? So it's a completely different profession. But again, I would just tell you, when I was doing my CA, all right, I did with all my heart when I did my chartered accountancy, and I'm truly blessed to be a chartered accountant as well. But my passion was something different. I really felt that after completing my CA, and it was not a cakewalk again. I'm not telling that acha maine exam diya and everything was done. It's not like that. I definitely had my ups and downs in my chartered accountancy journey. I had my attempts, but I think that was a blessing for me. As they say that failure is a stepping stone to success. Since our childhood, we have seen this particular idiom, but then I've experienced it when I failed. And I truly felt after, failing, I got those 2 months till 15 days, I was not knowing where am I? I don't know. I mean, how am I going to go ahead in life? And after 15 days, I truly believe that my parents and my school, you know, have been like pillars in my life. Jo jabhi bhi jitna bhi maine seekha hai ya jitna bhi maine grow kiya hai till date, I owe it to them, honestly. And my parents were there with me, and unhone mujhe kaha that there are only two options, Supal, you have in your life, right? There's nothing, yeah, you're crying, or you're still 15 days, you're thinking what to do, because failure is something, it strikes you over here. And first failure of my life was that. So I really felt that, yes, I have two options, either to give up and do something else, you know, chartered accountancy ko bye-bye keh do, or else give your best shot. So now I selected the second one. Yes, let me give my best shot. You know, why not? Just give it a best try again. Give my 500% again. So that was something which I took a decision. It's a choice which I made. I did my CA. I completed my exams. And then somewhere, I think this thought came in my mind. Is it something which I want to do all my life? The work which I did as a chartered accountant, do I want to do that? You know, after completing CA also. So this thought came in my mind. And since my schooling days, Aditya, as I shared with you, when I see you, I can see my little version, because when I was in school, I really loved stage. I loved speaking. I'm a people-oriented individual who loves being around people. Not realize this. After this failure, giving my best shot again and, you know, leaving to the Almighty what will happen in the result. I have given my best. And then those 2 months of my vacation, I got time to think. Is it this? Is it my calling? There I get the answer that no, I want to do something which is people oriented, which truly makes me feel happy when I get up in the morning to work, jump from my bed, and you know, I'm going to do this. So wahi se shuru hua, when I found out my passion, and then I researched a lot till 2 months after clearing CA also, till 2 months, I did not apply to any companies or firms for a job as a chartered accountant. Didn't think of going into practice. And 2 months, I was sitting at home and researching a lot about this field of training and development. And then I took certifications and I went ahead as a trainer. And right now, of course, I truly enjoy being in this noble profession. And I love this profession because main kehti hu na, it's like I eat, sleep and breathe. It's my passion. So passion converted into profession, I can say. And, you know, it's a great profession where we develop, enrich and enhance people every single day. So, yeah, that's in a brief my story, I could say.
That's actually pretty interesting. Your story gives us a learning that you should do whatever you want and not force yourself to do something that you believe that you cannot do for your whole life. So I learned that from your story, and then you kept going and going and let your passion drive you, and now you're here. So your story was a very inspiring and an interesting one. So after that, you told us that you started training people. Then please tell us about your endeavor of Step Ahead training program and how can people benefit from it?
Absolutely, absolutely. I have always, you know, felt this when I started my training journey. At that time, I was working as a professional. I'm also on the panel with Government of Gujarat. You know, I'm from Surat. I'm from Gujarati Baniya family, family of professionals. I could say my dad is a doctor and we are all professionals. So now when I started my training journey after I took certifications for soft skill training and, you know, coaching. And then when I was on the panel with them, I trained a lot of youngsters, you know, because when I'll just give you a simple example of why skill is very important, why the thing which I'm doing, why this transformation is needed in life, right? You like pizza, Aditya? You like pizza?
Yes.
I hope
everybody
so.
Likes
yes, you
pizza.
Love. Yes, Aditya will tell you. Yeah. At this hour, you are telling me, ma'am, about pizza. I mean, but yes, you like pizza, right? Now, if I tell you, Aditya, if there's a pizza with me right now and I'm giving you the base of the pizza, the base, the fresh dough with which we make the base, right? I give you the base, not the toppings. Will you love having it?
No.
Oh, yeah, you know that you want the toppings, you want the pizza sauce, the veggies, the cheese, you know, all those things are needed. Absolutely. That is our life, you know, because the degree which you take or the education you take, which is very important for sure, that's the base. If you don't have the base, how are you going to keep the toppings, right? So you need the base. But along with the base, if you want that people, when you go out, you know, out of your educational institute, or, you know, when you go in out and meet people out there, you should be an overall package, I would say, a holistic development, which is very important. So the topping, which I talked about, that's what I do. We truly, you know, I craft programs for life skills and soft skills for individuals, for teenagers, for students like you, for professionals, for businesses and everyone out there. And these programs have benefited in a way that gives you the topping in life, because there are a lot of people, they are knowledgeable, they know many things, but they are not able to present themselves. They are not able to get that, you know, reach that pinnacle of success because they don't have life skills in their hands. And that is what I do, the topping. So One Step Ahead is the name of my firm. As I said, I started my journey with the Government of Gujarat, and of course, a lot of one-on-one consulting and coaching and, you know, dealing with a lot of teenagers, a lot of youngsters of the age group of 20 to 26, and a lot of professionals, doctors, CS, architects, all those things. And then I felt somewhere that we all want success and we all want happiness, right? Then I don't think so. There are anyone, even your viewers, if I ask them, ek bhi jan aisa nahi hoga, they don't want success, right? They don't want happiness in life. We all want. So many a times to get that success, there is just one step which we need to take. Be it we want to learn something new, learn a new skill, or maybe we want to take some knowledge. There is only one step which is needed. Or we want to upgrade our knowledge, upgrade our skill, upgrade ourselves, right? One step. So it is One Step Ahead. That's the name of my firm. Why? Because you just need that one step, not focusing on the whole path and the whole staircase, just one step. And taking that one step, that's what exactly I do. I become their catalyst to take that one step and transform their life with our programs on life skills and soft skills, which we, you know, broadly call essential skills. Yeah.
Yeah. as they say, I heard a saying that the journey is easy from 70% to 90%, but the actual journey, which is hard, is from 90% to 100%. So the skills, the values, the leadership, the soft skills and everything like that, that brings you from 90% to 100 to absolute perfection. And well, that's something you and I believe in common. Now I would like to ask, yes, how do you train
that.
People yeah, well, I would like to ask, how do you train people and unfold their true potential? What magic spell do you use? And well, when it comes to empowering and employability training, please tell us about when it comes to empowering and employability training skills.
Well, as you said, Aditi, the magic is not with me. The magic is in you, in each individual. You know, the treasure is hidden inside. We just do one thing. We just help them find their true treasure within, right? So through these programs, basically, they are crafted, as I said, they're customized in a way to help individual and associations or organizations as per their needs. Now, what exactly I do with these programs is, There is, you know, I understand the person, what is their role and goal in their life. And accordingly, all the programs are crafted in a way. All these training programs, my training programs basically are, you know, it is based not only on knowledge, it is content based, it is experiential, it is case study based, it is, you know, fun filled. And you, Ketena, there is, I'm a Gujarati, so I would just use that ramta ramta shikhu. That means while, you know, you learn while you play. So a fun filled, it is very fun filled, energetic, and it is very creative. I try and humbly try and make these programs so interesting that people learn through play, you know, be it any age group. So that is how I help them find their true treasure, be it finding their purpose in life, or be it finding their hidden, you know, that, you know, enhancing their confidence and self-esteem, or maybe communication, public speaking, also being people oriented, being, you know, people's person, being interpersonal skill, body language, presentation skills. So you name it and that is there. But if it's customized, you go in a restaurant and they don't offer you everything. Whatever you ask for is offered. And that's what exactly I try doing with all the people who seek, you know, you come to us. Yeah.
Well, that certainly is an interesting point of view. And I would like to ask something. How can my viewers, or some of my viewers who lack motivation, because how can they like learn from you and benefit from your program?
Absolutely.
And contact you, basically.
Yes, basically, yes. They can, of course, contact me through Instagram. Instagram page for my firm is the One Step Ahead Super Talati Supal. And they can also reach me out from Facebook with One Step Ahead again. And also my personal account as well, CA Supal Talati. Even my email ID is there. And either if you can, you know, write it down in your description box on YouTube, they can also email me from there. And yes, as far as the motivation is concerned, I think... it's very important to understand one thing for everyone out there. Motivation is very important in our life. And I know, because we all have a roller coaster ride to face, be it, you know, it's my life or it's Aditya, your life, or anyone out there who's listening to us. But then intrinsic motivation is very important, right? If you're motivated from within, if you are your best friend, I think everything is very simple. So that is also always focus. Of course, I'm there with you, and I'll be more than happy to, you know, communicate and take your journey forward together, being your catalyst, your transformational catalyst with you. But one thing you remember every time, whosoever is motivating you, just believe first. Intrinsically, intrinsic motivation is something which is very important, and we help you to find that intrinsic motivation and drive through life. Yeah, so that's,
yes, yeah, it is said that someone can only show you the path of life, you have to walk it yourself. Well, you certainly show many people.
So hand-holding is something which we do.
Please continue.
Yes, I was just saying that hand holding is something which we do, and as you said, that then you have to take the path already, and that I think that empowers people. The training and the coaching which we give, you know, I truly enjoy that. The best part I like about my profession is, you know, when I see people after the training and they come with a smile on their face and they say that there is a transformation. We've applied what you've, you know, taught us, and we've applied that, and I think that is the biggest reward, when that smile and that satisfaction is there on their face when they meet us. So, and one more thing, I really enjoy these lines. So if you allow me, I'll just share one wonderful, you know, few lines which I always remember. Do I do that?
Yep.
Yes. Okay, so that's in Hindi. So basically, I'll of course tell what does that mean also. I had read this somewhere and that has really touched me, that zindagi ki har subah kuch sharte leke aati hai aur zindagi ki har sham कुछ तजुर्बे देख के चली जाती है. सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट द चॉइसेस यू मेक. सो एज दिस पर्टिकुलर लाइन से दैट इन द मॉर्निंग, यू नो, व्हेन वी गेट अप, वी आर फ्लडेड विद चैलेंजेस थ्रू ऑल अराउंड, एंड द वे वी चूज टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू दोस चैलेंजेस एट द एंड वी डिटरमाइन द एक्सपीरियंसेस. सो दैट्स व्हाट लाइफ इज ऑल अबाउट. सो मोटिवेशन विल कम व्हेन यू स्टार्ट टेकिंग थिंग्स लाइक दैट, व्हेन यू स्टार्ट having a different perspective in life, you know. If I say that the glass is there, as they already say, glass is half full and half empty. So how do you see it? It's your call.
Yes. Now, thank you for sharing that. And I will share all the links, your Instagram link and your email ID in the description below. So viewers, if you want to learn from ma'am and you're inspired by her, then please check out the links in the description below. And well, I would like to ask that with the changing times, like kids have been like very comfortable upbringing, and they have very comfortable upbringing in their house, and they have an easy life, which makes them vulnerable to high ego, and sometimes they become arrogant or too sensitive. How to work on such issues and more insight on soft skills.
Right. So for that, the thing which you told about comfort zone, Aditya, I think also, of course, as you said, in these times that they have a very comfortable upbringing. Very, very true, very true. Along with that, I think for everyone out there, if you want to develop in life, if you want to go ahead, remember one thing, you have to come out of your comfort zone, because growth is outside comfort zone, right? So, bahut zaruri ho jata hai. And kahin na kahin, I think for these kids, I would like to tell the parents, you know, the kids should have the experience which, you know, which would definitely develop them. Don't think as if, because I, of course, all the parents want their kids to be very much, you know, in their shell and very much protected. And I'm okay with that. All right. I understand that. But if you want your kid to get developed, it is very important to just, you know, throw them in the water. They will learn to swim. Have faith on your child. You be with them as their backbone, but just don't handhold them. As they say, you know, when I give a lot of insight on parenting also, different sessions on parenting, in that I mentioned one thing. There are two kinds of parents, all right? One parent is helicopter parenting, okay? And one is ambulance parenting. Let me just throw light on that. Helicopter parenting means those parents who are always there for their kids, means they are hovering around and they are not letting. Agar bachcha chal raha hai, and if the parents see there is a pit there, they will tell, arre beta, don't. Do not fall into that. So that is helicopter parenting. You are always protective about your child. You are like, no, that person should not have any failures or anything like that. And ambulance parenting are those parents who are also with their child. But they are, when ambulance comes, when there is an emergency. So they let their child explore life. And when that child needs, you know, at that time, the parent is always there like an ambulance. So please, all the parents, I want to tell that give your child a time to explore and time to, you know, see their life with their own perception. Then they will develop in something which you will be proud of. Right. So, yes. And of course, soft skill, as you said, and I talked about comfort zone. When I take a lot of sessions on public speaking and presentation also, and there is one thing which everyone asks me, that how can we speak on stage? You know, we are really having stage fear, and it's so, honestly, comfort zone se bahar aana bahut zaruri. You know, cut that branch. If you're sitting on a branch, if you cut it, then only you'll fly. right? So it's very important. And it comes to any soft skills, communication skill is very, very, very important, need of the hour. Being people oriented, because you're surrounded with people, you have to connect with people. That is interpersonal skill. You have to learn that for everyone out there. Communication skill, people skill, these, I mean, this is very, very important. We have to manage people. You are not in an era that you are surrounded with robots, all right? So we have to deal with people. So you should be a people oriented individual. And it's not that you have to fake it. You know, it's natural. And if you learn this skill, it's a learning. Skill means what? You can learn it. You can adapt it, right? And definitely you'll see your life will change. So soft skill is something, yes. The topping, as I said, well, topping is very important, you know, in life, very much.
Yeah, I also believe that. You know, parenting, a child is like another startup for a parent. And well, I believe that. And when you said, when you talked about soft skills, well, when a few years ago, I was also like that only. I had very big stage fear and I was afraid to go on stage. So my mother and father, they pushed me and they said, karke aao tum, kabhi hum tumhe aane denge. So I went and first time, second time, third time, I failed. I could not speak too good. But after 1 year of practice and speaking and all, I lost my shyness and all of that. And I was open on the stage. And well, after that, my speaking skills came on to YouTube and this came up. Well, wow. I also believe that you always have to be a people-oriented. Yeah.
Yes. You are also a source of inspiration to many, Aditya, honestly. So I think your story which you shared right now, I'm going to share it with all my students as well.
Well, see, you have to become a people-oriented person if you want to become a leader, because leadership is all about maximizing the efforts of a group and leading to them towards a goal. And if you don't know how to talk to people and deal with them, then you can never make a team. And well, that is very crucial to becoming a leader and a successful person also. So emotional intelligence is also a very big problem, topic these days. And can you please give me, please tell me what is emotional intelligence and how will it impact the future? And please tell me about that.
Absolutely. See, emotional intelligence, a wonderful question, Aditya, because I think people should be aware about this. Emotional intelligence is the need of the hour, because your emotions definitely determine your decision also, right? The decisions which we make are backed by emotion in something or the other way, directly or indirectly. Now, what is emotional intelligence? A wonderful, a wide topic, of course, but just to tell you in brief, I'll just give you again one example. And an example I'll give you. See, if, for example, this is a bottle of Coke, hai na, man lijiye, imaginary. So this is a bottle of Coke. And if I'm, you know, shaking it like that, and if I open it, what will happen? Fizz will come out, right? Bilkul, yes. But now, yeah. If this is a bottle of water, filled of water, and I do this, and I open it.
No problem.
Nothing, right? Exactly that is emotional intelligence. When you move from reaction to response, Anna, what we do generally, people act first, all right? If we talk about anger, for example, they act first, then they stop and then they think, oh, I should have not done that. So now emotions are overpowering. Now, if the cycle is reversed, if I stop, if I think, and then if I act, that is response. It's not reaction. So the bottle which I showed you over here of the cold drink is a reaction. Because when people, there are some situations, if someone tells me something and I'm, you know, my emotions will be overpowering. Then, arre yaar, ab toh I'm going to, you know, kill that person now. But that is, cycle should be reversed. That is emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence is your ability to manage your emotions in such a way that the emotions work for you. And that is possible when you go from reaction to response. Right? Respond to a situation. First stop, then think, and then act. You will definitely see the change in your life. And a lot of people who have taken emotional intelligence sessions with us, I mean, they have, or any, you know, there are a lot of trainers who are doing this. I'm so happy that we all are doing this together. But whenever you get a chance, take a training or take a session on emotional intelligence. I am sure your life will change.
Yes, well, emotional intelligence is basically analyzing the situation before acting. And well, I would like to ask a question. EQ is important or IQ? Which is more important? And can you give an example, please?
Right, absolutely. IQ, yes, of course, it is important. Your intelligence is important. But more important, if you ask, in my humble opinion, it's EQ, emotional quotient. The reason being, as I always said, again, I'll go to the pizza. See, I'm a very foodie person. And so, kahin na kahin, all those examples will keep coming in. So now, when I talk about pizza, it's again the same thing. You know, IQ is important. As I talked about the hard skill, matlab jo technical skill, the education, the degree which I talk, it's called the hard skill. Now, EQ, emotional quotient is how you can manage your emotions, how you can deal with people, how you can connect with people, how you can, you know, communicate well and present yourself. So EQ is the need of the hour. Maybe you'll get a job on the basis of IQ, on the basis of the degree. That's also, again, not when we take interviews, there are a lot of people, you know, we see the attitude, we see their soft skills more than what is on their paper, because paper will never define who the person is. But again, chalo maan liya, if you get a job based on your degree or something, but how much you'll be successful, how much you will be, you know, going ahead in your field will determine, it will be determined by EQ. So emotional quotient is very important. Work on that, because there's a need of the hour. And I'm telling all the people out there who are your age also, Aditya, I'm so happy. You know, as you mentioned that you are also having stage fear. Everyone has stage fear. Okay, it's not that I'm speaking since so many years, so I don't have. Everyone has it. Little hota hai. It's how you manage that fear. And how, after you practice, that doesn't matter much. You know that. Goes on, and fear hona chahiye, otherwise you not perform well, right? So even as a kid, I was also, when I started, my parents had the same thing. This resonated with me, so I just want to mention, my parents used to tell me in my school also, I and my teachers as well, used to push, you know, go on the stage. And from the very young age, I started going on stage, be it a small or big stage, and dheere dheere That stage became my home, hai na? Wo mera ghar ho gaya, and I became so comfortable on that it was never, I have to go on a stage. So fear is there, nervousness is important, but then after practice, after just jumping into the water, you start swimming. Right?
Yes.
So EQ, of course, yes, is important, as you mentioned, you know, about the question. At the end, I could say that.
Yes, and well, you know, I will share an interesting story. Henry Ford was once like interviewed by a reporter, and he asked many questions related to general knowledge and all that. So Henry, like, for the benefit of, like, for the knowledge of our viewers, Henry Ford was like one of the most brilliant leaders of the world. And so he could not answer any of those questions, all those general knowledge questions. But after the interview, Henry Ford said to the interviewer that I cannot answer these questions, but I can always bring a person in 10 minutes that who can answer all these questions. So that tells us it does not matter if how high IQ you have. It matters that you are able to manage people and you can persuade people. Then that will make you a leader, actually.
Absolutely, so wonderful sharing.
Yeah. So what is your take on work ethic and why is it important? Does it have any relevance in today's time?
As per my humble opinion, Aditya, of course, there would be different school of thoughts on this particular question. But I truly believe that I truly am a person who, you know, work on my value system. My value system is very set. And I think I truly determine working on that, because that will give me the satisfaction at the end of the day. That will help me sleep well, right? So work ethic and professional ethics is something which is very important. Of course, we give trainings or to corporates on the same, but of course, it is said, but people are, you know, not following, as you said, in the relevant time. But you have to do that. If you want to go ahead in life for very, very far, they have to definitely have this work ethic in place. And that is which you determine, your own self. It's not a rule book. Of course, there are few things which we have to follow. But that doesn't mean that you have to have that work ethic. You should have. I truly believe. I work on my value system, and that is very much set. Be it, maybe I'll get success a bit late, but I'm happy with that because I have followed what is right for me.
Yes. So please tell me about what are the good qualities of a good leader, and if you can cite an example so that we can learn that and like benefit from that.
Absolutely. Leadership, I think, what is leadership? You know, let me ask you that first. What do you think, Aditya?
Well, leadership is the ability, it's a social influence of people around you that maximize, and when you maximize the effort of the team towards the goal and you lead them according to the situation, that is leadership in my view.
Very nice, very nicely crafted, Aditya. Absolutely. If I have to tell what is leadership in three words, I can say making things happen. A leader is doing this, making things happen. How? By taking people along and empowering them to reach their best potential, right? Of course, a leader is someone who should walk the talk. The first thing, as you said, it's very important for a leader to walk the talk. If I am a leader, I'm telling that I'll be punctual. And if I'm not, then how will people, follow me? And a leader is not someone that, oh, chalo, mujhe follow karo, follow me. No, it's someone that influences people, as you said, that takes people along. They will come willingly. So as for the qualities, as you said, there are a lot, but my favorites are, the first is, a leader should be a visionary. Yes, he should be able to see what others don't right now. And visionary first. Second, I think he should have a good communication skill. Very, very important for anyone, not only leaders. I've been saying this many times in this interview today. So communication skill and being people oriented. If that leader is not able to connect to their teammates, how is he going to go ahead? Second. Third, a leader should first be a good team player. If he feels as if I am something else, yep. I am on this path and this is my team. No, I am a part of a team. It's not, and maybe I have been given the privilege to be a leader. That doesn't mean that the people out there don't have that. So he should be first a good team player as well. Also, as I said, walk the talk is very, very important. A leader, what a leader wants the team to do, he should do that. He should first do that. And a leader actually finds out the right person to give the right job. Means every person is having some strengths, some weaknesses. A leader is someone who is finding out yes. what is good in yes. someone and then helping them, empowering them that they can also be a best version of themselves, and how the goal of the team is also achieved at the same time. That's very, very important. So, being good in the people out there, the teammates, and then taking them along is very, very important as a leader, I feel. And as far as the examples are concerned, there are a lot of examples, but I truly feel that every person actually teaches us something. Sabko guru bano. So for leadership also, I think our mom is a good leader. Dad is a good leader. When it comes to certain things, when mom is a good leader, when it comes to certain things. So of course there are a lot of leaders. We look up to many people, but I think rather than only seeing the people who inspire us, and they do, I look up to them also, but I truly find leadership qualities all around our own circle and learn a lot from them as well.
Yes. So that was certainly interesting. As you said, those points were actually very true, and every person should incorporate them to their life wherever they lead. So if some of my viewers are children, they should if they are head boy or if they are class, like they should always try to lead, and people should always lead people in the way you said, because that was truly perfect. Now, why is empathy important to leadership? Well, please tell us about that, and can you elaborate on it?
Absolutely, absolutely. Before going into that question, I'll just take a minute. And as you said that those people are head boy or head girl, right? I'll just share my experience. I was in Lutz Convent High School. I'm so, so happy to be in that school. Blessed, I think, to have be in that school in Surat. And I was blessed to be the head girl in my tenure. So I think the leadership qualities which you talked about, I experienced the soft skills, I experienced the leadership quality when I was in my school. But now when I train people, I connect and realize all those learnings which I did there. So I have developed and evolved. That's why I said I owe to my school and my parents. So my school has been something which is, you know, a big blessing for me, a vardhan, I would say in Hindi, as we say. So not only a blessing, a vardhan. Of my school and my parents as well. So for all the students, for all the people who are young, I think just I want to tell you one thing. If you're in school or if you're in college, this is the age to explore. This is the age to take the plunge. If you get an opportunity to lead, take it. If you get an opportunity to speak, take it. If you get an opportunity to, you know, hone your skills, do it. Because this is the right age. As Aditya mentioned, you can see Aditya mentioned that his journey, how he was, and then he took this plunge, and now you can see him doing so well in life. So the thing is that you have to do it. Take the opportunity. Why wait? Why are you waiting? This is the best age to take that opportunity. Yeah. So coming back to your question, Aditya, empathy. Yes. Empathy yes. is basically the one thing which people get confused is empathy and sympathy. They think both are same. Let me just get very simple, you know, in this particular explanation. Empathy is just putting yourself in other person's place. Right? If you put yourself in some other person's place, you can feel and understand what that person is going through. And once we do that, of course, a leader needs that. Because if a leader understands the people out there, then only he can lead them, then only he can work for them. He can act as a bridge, right? So the thing is, empathy is something just, you know, putting yourself in someone else's shoes, as they say. Right. And if you go in someone else's shoes, yes. you should be ready yes. to take on their pain and feel it. Then only you can help them. Sympathy, on the other hand, is just feeling sorry about the situation. If you see someone who has failed and you see that person, are yaar, it's not right. No, he failed. Oh, I'm pitiable situation. But empathy is actually feeling the pain as if you are in that person's place. So it's very important to empathize. And when we talk about being people oriented or being a leader or being someone who is loved by everyone, empathy is very important. If you empathize with people, you can understand. It's a very wonderful thing which you can imbibe in your life and do that. It's very, very important. Don't be, when we just see our own self and our life, nothing. You should be a giver in that way. And if you can give, if you can empathize as well. Yes. So.
Yes. First of all, let's start from the beginning of your answer. You told about young age is the best way. You should start leadership at that age. Well, I certainly agree with you. And there are many examples across our history, our human history. You see Bill Gates, like he was one of the, at some point of time, he was one of the richest persons in the world. He started his journey in his teens only. And well, he saw the opportunity, he grabbed it, and now he's one of the greatest people. And whenever you see some successful startup, not necessarily, but whenever you see a startup or something like that, it started when someone was young. Because see, when you're young, you have drive, you have passion, you have emotion. And when you put that in a right way, and if you have clarity, many people don't have clarity at that age. And well, if you have clarity, then you can use that drive, that passion to go into the best way and go towards success. So that's what I believe. And empathy is, of course, also one of the best skills. And when you empathize with a person, you connect with them. You take the key and unlock their heart, and they become so close with you. And you can learn about them. You can share your thoughts with them. And when you do that, you become so close with a person that a person will always, well, if you are a leader, if it's your teammate, then he will always follow you, and he will always do the best thing, and he will do the greatest thing for your team and all that. So I believe that, and thank you for sharing such interesting knowledge.
I'll just add one more thing, Aditya, as you shared right now. When we talk about empathy, and I told you that putting yourself in someone else's shoes, right? Now, let us take this in a literal sense. So if, for example, you are there and your friend is there, right? Aditya and Aditya's friend. Now, I tell you both you are standing, all right? I tell you both that, okay, you have to go in each other's shoes. So what is the first thing which you will do?
First thing, I will talk with him. I will understand his emotions at current stage. And I will talk with him about recent events, his thoughts, his opinions. And he will do that with me. And then we will share thoughts. And then we will get into the discussion. And then all that will happen. And empathy will be created between both of us.
Bang on. Wonderful, Aditya. But let us, take this in a very literal sense again. Matlab, if I'm telling you, actually you have to go into that person's shoes. All right. The answer which you said, perfectly fine. That's the way you can empathize. But if you have to just go in other person's shoes, what is the first thing which you will do if you have to go in his shoes? In a literal sense.
Okay. So I will understand his background, his story, his everything he has done till now. And then I will do what I will understand it. I will try to empathize with him. And I will try to tell that what happened, that happened. And I understand what you are trying to say.
Okay. Very nice. So if literally I want to do that, no? So I have to first take out my shoes also. And if I want to go in someone else's shoes, as you said, very rightly, understanding that person, I have to take my shoes off first, or I can wear my shoes and go in his shoes. Not possible, right? Very, it's a very common thing. It's not possible. Eh? Yeah. So now the thing I want to explain here is, as you said, absolutely. First, we have to take our shoes off. If I want to go in someone else's shoes, I have to take my shoes off. Means if I want to empathize, I have to keep my mindset, I have to keep my opinion, my perception on a side. Then only I can understand that person's perception. So when you empathize, just have clear mindset. Okay, I am going to understand with an open mindset, which is very important in empathy.
Yeah, so that was pretty interesting, and that's a direct way to look at it, as you said. How to increase the emotional quotient? We discussed that, from reaction to response, but how to become that? Because the road from X to Z is very hard, and that's why, please tell us how to increase emotional quotient, and how can we be empowered by it, yet be balanced and grounded?
Right. The one thing which you mentioned, dear Aditya, grounded, which is very important in life. I think if you see the most successful people there, they are very much humble. They are very much down to earth. It's very important in life, howsoever successful you are, how much you achieve, always have that, stick to your roots is very important. Now, when it comes to developing EQ, as I said, of course, there's a lot of, it's a very huge discussion, and it takes a lot of, we have one day training programs for all those things. But just to tell you, as you said, just remember my example of that cold drink bottle and the bottle of water. So I told you a simple thing, pause, right? Stop. The pause button ko press karna hai. Stop. And think and then act. So for example, there would be situations, there are a lot of people who have anger issues, for example. So anger, when a person is saying something and you're being very angry, so tell yourself, 1 sec, you get 5 to 6 seconds, all right? You get 5 to 6 seconds to let your thinking brain participate. Your logic-based brain participate, not to just react, basically, right? So now when someone throws those triggers on, those things on you, then your emotions are triggered, I would say rather, that time, just, take a pause button and 5 to 6 seconds. You can do, as they say in Hindi, ulti ginti, 10, 9, 8, 7. You can do that also, reverse counting, something. But wait for that time. Because the time which you wait, your thinking brain, your rational brain will start acting in the right way. Okay, if that person is getting angry or that person is telling me something, then I have to think and act. I don't have to react. I have to respond. Now, how can I respond? So how will I respond? Okay, that person is getting angry. It's not like if that person has been telling something to me or is the same Hindi, talwar nikali hai usne, right? If he's fighting with a sword, I don't have to take my sword. I have to actually respond in such a way, all right, in a mature way. That person right now is not in a position to think that at least I have to think, right? This will change your life. This will help your emotional health, will definitely help you enrich and enhance your life. So if you see, this is not going to be a one day process. It is all going to, it's a, going to be a consistent effort. It is going to be a conscious effort also. Pehle, you have to follow these things and then it will be your second nature. So if any habit is formed, it will take time. It is not a one day thing, as we know, right? That's very important. And when it talks about EQ, developing that, of course, it takes a little time. It needs your commitment. It needs your right attitude to learn, because learning attitude, I feel, is very important in life. You have to keep learning. I have my grandparents who are 84 and they are learning right now how to operate YouTube also without my help, how to start Hotstar, how to start Prime Video. If they can learn, why can't we at this age? So there is no, all the time, and you listen to these people who are very successful, they will tell you that learning is a constant process. Have this in your mind every time. Keep learning and keep growing, because without learning, there is no growth.
Yeah. Well, what you said was pretty amazing and it was very interesting. See, when you don't react to a person, I believe there is a saying ki ladai do tarfa hoti hai, matlab ek taraf agar ladai na kare to fir dusri taraf bhi nahi karega, matlab in English I will explain it, that if one side does not react in an argument, then there will be no argument at all. So that's what I believe, and so that's what you correlate with me. What?
Absolutely. No, the thing which you said, that, you know, ladai ki jab baat ki, you know, argument ki jab baat ki, I'll just add one more thing. Always ask yourself, whenever you are in an argument, for anyone this is, ask yourself one thing. Is that relationship important or that argument? You know, winning that argument is important, or your relationship is important? You will get the answer, and then you will go from reaction to respond.
Yes, well, that thank you for sharing that advice. Please tell us about your favorite books, because you are such a big leader and you have such great knowledge, and you shared so much inspiration and such great knowledge that people can incorporate in their lives and go one step ahead. So please tell me about your favorite books and learnings from them.
Oh, that's so sweet of you, Aditya. I'm not a very big leader, please. I truly feel that, you know, I am very happy to share what I know, and I'm happy to learn. I've learned a lot of things from you right now, and I'm truly going to share this with my students as well to get inspired from your journey. So, yes, the books, as you said, there are many. But my personal favorite, I really love Robin Sharma. Okay, so because the way he puts his thoughts across, I think that resonates with my value system as well. So all the books by Robin Sharma, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari, then Who Will Cry When You Die, to name a few. I really love his books. I really love his work. And of course, Robin Sharma, I follow him a lot. I follow a lot of others as well. But if you ask about books, I really love his books also. There's one book, How to Win and Influence People. That is something which everyone should read.
By Dale Carnegie. By Dale Carnegie.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, yes, it's like one of the greatest books. Actually, it helped me communicate, and it's such an old book, but still it's a bestseller. It's a timeless book, actually.
Absolutely. Very nice. So that is also very nice. Then one book is by Stephen Covey, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. That's one thing which you should read for sure. And I think Gita is also one thing which you should have in your collection. It's a lot of management lessons, lot of lessons from Gita. They say that whenever we read Gita, every time, you know, if you've read it again, if you go back to it, you'll get solution to every problem. And that's true. So I'm not someone who is, you know, there will be a lot of people who are the spiritual leaders can guide us well. But I think that is something, the thing which you can understand, the concept which you can understand, at least that much you should know by reading Gita in a very simplest form as well. So that is one thing. And of course, I think catch hold of a lot of Ikigai. Ikigai is also a Japanese concept. Please do read that book as well.
Yes.
It's a wonderful concept, how to find your calling and purpose in life. So again, so those are a few books. Think and Grow Rich, again, you know, then Eat That Frog.
Yeah, by Napoleon Hill.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so I have all these books. And they are very interesting and they have such, so much knowledge. And well, Ikigai is a good one. It's I'm meaning it's Japanese tradition, but I believe the old time books and the old time culture is actual leadership. There is Sun Tzu's Art of War, and that book I read it and it impacted me from to my inner core, because it shares such deep leadership values and properties and all that. And then there's Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, and How to Influence People by Dale Carnegie. These two books are timeless, and then all the books you said were very interesting.
Two more.
Thank you for sharing them, and my viewers. Yeah.
Yes, Aditi. Just two more books, if you allow me. Just two more. One is The Alchemist. All right, you can read that. And the second is, I really love Gaur Gopal Dasji. You know, I really love and learn a lot from him. So I think his book is there, Life's Amazing Secrets. So I think that is also really good. You know, that will give you a different perspective of life, how you can be happy and contented. And you know, very, he has explained it, because Gaur Gopal Das has this, you know, the way he explains things is so in a simple language, and we really feel you know, it touches our heart right there. So I really love that book as well. So yes Aditi, over to you.
Yeah So thank you for sharing your favorite books. And well, what is your advice to my viewers out there to progress in general? What do you believe?
Absolutely. When we make food, right? I'm foodie, as I said, right? When we make food, if I have all the masalas, all right, I put all the masalas, I garnish everything very well. But if I don't put one thing, that food would not taste well. What would that be?
Salt.
Perfect. Yes, Aditya, salt. Exactly. So I'm going to, you know, share few ingredients who act like salt in your life. See, there would be different mantras of life. What is my, as you asked me, what is my mantra? I'll humbly just give my opinion. And I followed it in my life. So to be happy, I think, to be happy, first thing is very important. Do not focus or do not make your happiness dependent on your success. Oh, absolutely. You know, I'll explain you what I said. Do not depend on success to be happy, I would say, right? Because happy people are more successful rather than successful people being happy. I've given an example for that. There are students or anyone, you know, when we are young and when we come in 10th standard, my 10th standard, my board will be good. You know, I'll get these much marks. I'll be very happy. Okay, then 12th. I'll be very happy if I get this much marks and I get an admission in this particular college. All right, now I'll get, you know, in this particular company, I'll get my dream job. I'll be happy. Then everything, every time the goal will change, but your happiness should not.
And right? Goal so will not increase. Depend
success. Yes, what he said.
Sorry, there was my dog, he came here, and sorry, he disturbed.
It's okay.
Well, that is, yeah,
yes.
Well, no, that was certainly interesting. And
and yeah, one more thing I'll share. You know, I have one more thing, because I'm really enjoying communicating and, you know, interacting with you, Aditya. So I truly want to, you know, share what I believe. So, yeah, so that is one thing. Second, always love yourself. All right. When we talk about confidence building, when we talk about self-belief, you know, if you love yourself and accept yourself as you are, and then you, of course, improve enhance your abilities, I would say. That's the best thing. Second, third, have gratitude in life. We are truly blessed. If you count your blessings, the list would be endless. Right. At this particular juncture, like in this particular times of pandemic, we are alive. That is the biggest thing. You know, be grateful that you are alive, you're breathing. So something like that. Have gratitude, you know, accept gratitude in your life. Be thankful to your parents if you're a kid. Be thankful to your spouse. Be thankful to your family. Be thankful to every people. Be thankful to your colleagues. Whosoever is making a difference in your life, that is very important. And a never give up attitude is very, very important. That's what I have learned, because you don't die by falling in water. You die by staying there. If you start swimming, you're going to reach the bank very soon. Right? So those are the things which I truly believe that passion should be, whatever you do it with a lot of passion. Be it your job, be it anything. Aap karo, dil se karo, otherwise you will not be happy and successful. You will not enjoy life. This journey of life will never be enjoyed if you don't enjoy your work, if you don't enjoy every single thing. If you're eating, enjoy that moment. If you are working, enjoy that moment. Do it with 100%, 1000%, whatever you say. Do it with a lot of, you know, you're giving your 100% commitment to that. Life will be beautiful. Passion is everything, I would say.
Yes. Thank you. Well, I would like to, you said passion is everything. And I also believe that if you have passion for something, that drives you towards your goal. And passion is actually passion. When you have a passion for something, no, people also are attracted to you. And they also see your passion and they want to contribute towards your goal. And that all happens. And I have experienced it in my life also. It is very interesting. Now, who are your role models from whom you have been inspired the most? Because see, your journey, your leadership cannot come without inspiration. And well, I also have many inspirations. So please tell me about your inspirations and who are they and why?
Right. So, yes, of course, the greatest leaders are there, right? Be it APJ Abdul Kalam, be it Mahatma Gandhi, right? I am truly inspired. But as I said, I, you know, seek a lot of inspiration from people around me as well, be it my parents. I am truly inspired by my mother. The way she has the power of being, you know, a power of doing things with such the passion which you talk, she is also very passionate in whatever she does. So I think the way she goes ahead, the never give up attitude, the way she drives her life, you know, be it anything, kuch bhi usko karna hai, she's of course, you know, taking care of everyone out there. If she's not well also, she'll give 100%. I think all the mothers. So I think I have learned a lot from my mother, the never give up attitude, the going ahead attitude without any, without thinking anything, you know, doing her job, hamesha, never, if she's tired, whatever it is. So she has given me a lot of teachings when it comes to leadership as well. I'm truly, truly inspired by my mom. Second, of course, my dad. I think the way he sees things, the way he understands life, I think that is something which I have learned from him and I keep learning from him. So he's a doctor, and the way he treats his patient and the way he serves people, I think that is something which I, day in and day out, I'm inspired. The way he speaks, the way he takes decision, all these things are very important, I think, as a leader. The way he has the EQ. My mom also has a very good EQ, I would say. So those people. And of course, as I said, whenever I grew up, during my schooling days, I was in my school, to my teachers and all those people. I keep learning from everyone. I keep learning from those people who, just say for example, just simple example I give you. I was just going, before pandemic I'm talking, right, at that time. I was going through my city and I had to take a halt on a signal. And bahut dur, there was a person selling bananas, all right, just bananas. So now this person did not have a degree of marketing, of course, right? But he was very good in sales and marketing. What he did, in one hand, he had bananas, 3 to 4 bananas. And in one hand, he had his 10 rupee note. So from that distance, I could make out that, yes, he's telling 10 rupee note mein these many pieces of banana will come. Right? So everyone out there could see there, and then people would feel, yeah, let me take it at, you know, banana, let me take it. Agar ye nahi karta, no one would notice him. So I think we are learning from every person, be it leadership or be it any life present. That's what I said, sabko guru banao. It's very important in life. So if we keep learning something or the other from different people, I think that will help us build our life in the right way. You should have that observation. And that is very true. More than the books, yes. Books of course, but more than that, the observation skill will also help you to enhance your life and develop your life into a better version of yourself.
Certainly. Well, as you said, that marketing story was very exciting. And that was certainly a good way of advertising himself to the people on the road. He had a great tactic, and well, you talked about something very interesting. Now, please share two people whom you would like to see on the show, like whom you would like to see on the show. Two people.
The people whom I know. That's what you're saying.
Yes. Any two people who would
like to see on the show. Sorry, Aditya, I lost your voice. So I can't take her name. Forum was already there and inspired. Yes, Aditya, not very much, but I understood your question. Can you hear me properly?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
2, 1.
Yes. So you asked me the people who I want to see on this show, right? All right. So there's one trainer, a coach in Surat, you know, Meenakshi Bhatnagar ma'am. I think she's a wonderful person, and she can also be on the show. She's a wonderful inspiration, I think, when it comes to women also, and to everyone out there, she can be on the show. And one more name, if I have to take, I think... my mentor, when I told about KCG, right, when I told about Government of Gujarat, I would say KCG is a part of that. And Government of Gujarat, the person who is heading our project, finishing school project, Dr. Nandini Kanan, and she is someone who's been a source of inspiration to me for sure, very much. And she's done a great work in the field of education. So I think those two names I would like to humbly opine from my side.
Thank you. I will certainly try to contact them, and you can share their numbers. That would be a great deal of help. But now let's move on to the next thing. Lastly, I hope you enjoyed the show. Please advise anything you liked about Aditya Talks, and any suggestions which should be incorporated to improve the experiences for our viewers.
Absolutely. As I've always said, and I started with that, Aditya, that when I see you, I see my mini version, and I'm so, so, so happy to see you doing such a wonderful job. As I said, you are a champion, and a champion is a person who keeps going and sharing his ideas and his thought processes to world as large. I think you are... At this age, you're doing so well. I truly think that when you'll reach, when you'll be growing up, you will be somewhere else. And then I'll be coming to you and telling, Aditya, you remember I had been on your show once, and can you just give me your autograph? So, that time, please give me the autograph. And that is going to happen for sure, because you're going to go ahead truly amazingly. Yeah. So no suggestions. I think you're doing a fabulous job, Aditya, at this age. And I truly enjoy interacting with you. I enjoy working with a lot of kids and teenagers of your age. I think that really helps me learn also from them. And I've learned a lot of things from you as well, Aditya. So thank you so much for this wonderful experience. I am going to add you in my treasure box of memories. And definitely, this is going to I'm going to take this home, along with all the other things which we talked today. I'm sorry to interrupt you, Aditya. I'm not able to get Thank you so much, Aditya, for having me. And it's a pleasure meeting you. I truly would cherish these moments for a lifetime. It is a wonderful experience. And I really wish we could meet in person very soon. Yes. So all the best to you. And you're going to go ahead, you know, very well in your life. You're going to achieve everything. Wishing you loads of success, loads of happiness. Just keep going and always be the champion which you are. Thank you so much.